We begin tonight with a follow-up on a News 15 Investigates report that friendly fire killed Lafayette Police Senior Corporal Cejas Jolivet.
As we first told you last night here on News 15, multiple law enforcement and government sources confirm that Officer Jolivet was killed by another officer's weapon during a SWAT standoff in Jenneret 2 weeks ago. Now, in the wake of our reporting, the NAACP is calling for changes at LPD. The organization wants more transparency in policing, including the release of body camera video to promote transparency, accountability, and trust between law enforcement and the community. The suspect in the SWAT operation that police say put the deadly day into motion has still not been charged in the incident. And as News 15 Investigates reported last night, our legal analyst says that suspect could still face a first-degree murder charge for Corporal Jolivet's death. But many of you at home tonight are wondering about the officer who fired the deadly shot and if they can be held accountable. We took that question to LSU Law Professor Ken Levy.
Given the general situation, a SWAT team, dangerous, is receiving, gunshots from a dangerous suspect, and they're doing their best to handle this very dangerous situation. My guess is that the officer was doing his best, his or her best, and this would not be a case of recklessness or negligence on their part. But it all depends on the circumstances. For example, if they were just spraying, again, recklessly or negligently, that might get that officer in trouble. It's all going to depend on the circumstances.
Our News 15 Investigates report on friendly fire was also shared on social media by the press secretary for Louisiana Attorney General Liz Murrell. We're told the attorney general is aware of the situation but is not yet ready to comment. And if you'd like to watch that News 15 Investigates report in its entirety, full coverage of the story can be found over at KADN.com.